first ever crash on the PS5. Marvel's Avengers.
Hello, beta testers. 6. That's the amount of crashes I tolerated on my brand new PlayStation 5 before I stopped playing this mess. After 7 months, 2 villains, 1 enemy type, 0 Marvel locations, no endgame, broken dailies, in a live service, a 7-month-old live service. And before we get into it, if you're a defender desperate to flex that beta energy in the comment section on that actually there are 3 villains now, let me stop you there. Here in reality, we only count villains when they actually work, as in function. And just like the launch, when the 2 villains on offer couldn't even work, reskinned Hulk is the same way. Buggy, glitchy, lazy. There are no phases or real mechanics in these brain-dead, uninspired boss encounters, so it's perplexing when Crystal Dynamics is so in love with reskins. Why? Why haven't you just swapped out the model for a boss, given them an intro line, and injected dozens of supervillains into this game? At least enough to match the amount of heroes that you have. They don't all need a song and dance. Your game needs content. But in a GameSpot interview with Scott Amos, the head of Studio Crystal Dynamics makes it clear that he regards custom harm rooms as endgame content. Wow. Do you mean the harm training rooms? Described as the virtual training modules? In which we engage in holographic augmented reality virtual training? The training is the end game? Bitch, what the fuck is wrong with you? You need an educational slap. I'm not sure stupidity like this exists. Crystal Dynamics, you clearly do not exist in the same realm as competence. If you think training can be endgame, and furthermore, that Star Trek's holodeck or X-Men's Danger Room could ever have gotten away with being so creatively bankrupt that they couldn't even change the environment. There couldn't be a little bit of set dressing. You already have the assets in the game to dress up one room, but you're stupid, lazy, uninspired, or some miraculous combination of more terrible words that I can't imagine, because this is dog shit. Can't change the environment in a holographic room. That's Marvel's Avengers. Can't even set modifiers to properly test potential builds. There's no ability for players to even save different gear loadouts to a build locker, because of course that isn't a feature. No stat pages for players to even see how much, how often, or the total amount of times used or missions completed or asses kicked. Nothing. 7 months after launch, you're hyping up your next-gen version, only to be blindsided by your own foolishness. You somehow coded and built the data migration feature into the PS4 version, yet couldn't remember to communicate that you needed to use this and how to do so to your own players? Bruh, this doesn't just result in you looking foolish, Crystal Dynamics. Sony looks bad because of the publication of an obvious shortcoming that Xbox players do not experience, since their smart delivery makes it as easy as logging in the year 2021. After 7 months, beta testers, 2 villains, 1 enemy faction, 0 Marvel locations, the dailies are still broken, the cosmic vendors are not working, you're seeing problems you saw at launch still. You can buy cosmetics with real money, no problem though. But is it okay if some of those PS5 skins aren't appearing the way that they're supposed to be looking because of texture glitches? It's okay, because in the past when skins have been broken, they've stayed broken for a month. If I'm lying, I'm flying. This game could have implemented procedural generation to shuffle room types and create fresh layouts for villain sectors, leading up to different supervillains to surprise the player from playthrough to playthrough. The layouts and the settings may be recognizable, but at the very least, The variety would lend to slightly unique sessions. Minecraft Dungeons does this. Path of Exile does this. But these are actual looter games that are smart enough to respect the players and incentivize multiple playthroughs by rewarding the time that they invest. And that's why Path of Exile's average player base is over 20 times healthier than Marvel's Avengers can manage right after an apparently huge content drop. So huge, you can't even finish it because it's that bugged. So easy, hardcore tryhards like Godslave can end boss encounters in seconds. But as usual, the most exciting things about Marvel's Avengers isn't in the game yet. It's been out for 7 months, but boy oh boy, wait until you see what's coming next. You see this Black Panther trailer? Does that have a release date? No? What happened to Spider-Man? Remember he was supposed to be coming out March? It's March now. And you're telling us that, he's coming out after Black Panther, who also doesn't have a release date?
Oh my god. And it takes them 3 months. Oh, it takes them 3 months to implement DLCs.
You know, even in the midst of Fortnite's explosively lucrative collaborations with Marvel, among others, they take the time to represent their fans by incorporating the artwork and sometimes skin concepts right into the game. Meanwhile, Crystal Dynamics ignores its dwindling yet incredibly insightful and intelligent fan base in favor of a cult of ball garglers and a committee of ass kissers that they have carefully chosen to proudly ignore the game's many faults, because ironically, they're somehow unaware that they're helping this comatose vegetable of a game to its eternal rest. It genuinely breaks my heart to see users in my Discord banned for wanting what makes sense, a functioning game, communication, competent developers. But unless they have exclusively nice things to say about this 7 month ongoing train derailment, you ignore them. Almost as hard as you ignore reason, logic, the urge to be a respectable group of individuals running a fucking studio. User Doodoo Fart in my Discord says quite simply, "I just want to fight comic book villains." It's a pretty sensible request, right? That maybe 90% of people who are buying a superhero game might expect. 8 heroes, 2 villains. And with bugs lasting 7 months, I guess it's not hard to see why. Because when refusing to communicate isn't an option, lies are apparently the way to go, right, Crystal Dynamics? XP increases necessary, but not to artificially increase grind, but because perk points are overwhelming and confusing to gamers. Training qualifies as endgame. Failing to communicate for 7 months on a game so buggy that the multiple times you released it, the dailies were not functional in your live service game. It took you 7 months to get to a campaign replay. No apology. Your idea of accountability, as usual, is to ignore it. Crystal Dynamics, we are quite frankly worried for you. Stop hurting yourself. Anonymously contact Jason Schreier and end this. Most people could have their arms broken and go blind and still recollect more attractive Avengers than you have managed to execute in this garbage pile of a game. The Avengers are already profitable and you are forcing alterations and exaggerating the popularity and appeal of bullshit characters that nobody asked for because you're really trying to make it seem like people give a shit about this when what they really want is this. Congratulations on making progress, but you wouldn't agree that this is worthy of the $60 investment that you are asking people. Your game's beautiful on PS5, but there's still nothing to do. Maybe $30 worth of campaign. There's nothing to do. This meme doesn't get any more clear. Before this is fixed, you'll continue to fail. Y'all want to move the needle when it pertains to players? You need not one, not four, at least 6 different supervillains for players to fight. You need another enemy type. You need some Marvel locations. You need loot worth chasing. And if your loot in your looter offers no cosmetic change, your skins need to be that much more satisfying for players to compensate. For more information on Marvel's Avengers' lack of visual appeal, watch this other video of mine. Come to your own conclusions, but don't forget this treatment. Thank you for subscribing. 600 likes and I'll make another Marvel's Avengers video.